And I flew in yesterday. And you know, there's one thing that I love about flying Indian Airlines is the fact that you can understand what the pilot is saying. Yeah? Any other airlines, even American Airlines, you can't understand. I'm from Dubai. Arabic Airlines? Hell no. You have no idea what they're saying. This is what the pilot sounds like.
This is your captain speaking. So we are going to be flying to 30,000 feet. Serving you today will be Sunita, Kavita, Papita, Lalita. And
shut up, man. And I've just started flying business class. Before that, I used to fly semi-business class. I'll explain to you what that means. I used to sit on the first seat of economy and half my leg used to be in business class shaking like that. I'm a Sindhi, so I think that says a lot about how things are. I've been traveling all over the world. It's so much fun doing this for a living. But you know, every time I travel to London, anybody from the UK here? Right here, hello. I love the accent. It's so, you can say anything. Hello, my name's Nitin. Nice to meet you. What's your name, eh? Is it that bad? Somebody put him on pause. Play. But you know, every time I travel, I have people from England always telling me, come up to me, it's like, hello, Nitin. You're right, mate. Listen, right. I have a question for you. Why do all you Indian people, all of you, not some, just all of you, speak so bloody fast all the time? Why? I'll tell you why, sir. Do you know it's almost $2 a minute to call outside India? It's expensive. And I love being Indian because Indians, we make everything work for us. For example, sir, in India, if a car stops on the road, it becomes a roundabout. We don't move the cow. We give directions using the cow. We call, Rajesh, from the cow, you take a left. There's a horse. I'm standing right behind the horse. Come, come. That's how we do it. That's how it works for us. Like I mentioned, this is what I do full time. I don't have a regular job. But I think they ask you stupid questions at job interviews. Anybody from HR here? Anybody dealt with HR? Not achar, as in I'm sure the creative people like achar. Mango pickle, yes, let's make it. So they ask you stupid questions at job interviews. The last job interview I went for, they ask you this one question every time, yeah? So, Mr. Mirani, where do you see yourself in this organization in the next 2 years? I said, in your seat, bro. He didn't find it funny. They says, so Mr. Mirani, tell us, how do you handle a stressful situation? I just bloody got up and left. How else? And I don't know why they have to ask you personal questions. Like, bro, I don't know you. You don't know me. We just met. Why do they have to get personal? I mean, what the hell is last position held and for how long? Well, that's between me and my girlfriend. Why should I tell you? Chinese people, these guys can go from really happy to really confused in 1.2 seconds. I love these guys. True story. I was in Hong Kong. I saw these two Chinese people talking to each other. And all I heard was this. And one of them got confused while they were talking to each other. So Chinese guys talking. Ha! Sawla! Sawla! Somdu jizga! Somdu! Somdu jizga! Sawla! Somdu jizga! So, one of them got confused. So, someone like, so, Songlo. Songlo. Pa, pa. Crazy. And it's impossible to get a deal from these guys. You walk, how many meals do they eat? They eat 78 meals a day. You walk into the store, they're always eating. You walk into China, Hong Kong, or any Chinese store. Excuse me, how much is. So excuse me, there's t-shirt. You get angry, you're like, excuse me, how much is it? And everything is just for you. Okay? Okay, okay. This for you, okay. This for you, okay. Just for you, special flights, okay? Only $20 for you, just for you, okay? Only for you, only for you, okay? What do Indian people say? I'll give you $2. That's why the Chinese are pissed off. They say 20, we say 2. Now, this Chinese person could be standing against a wall. Nothing behind. They are standing in the middle of a desert. There's nobody around them. They will still look back and negotiate with somebody. Every time you ask them, okay, for you, Kamala. Who is Kamala? Who the hell is Kamala and what is she doing in every shop in China? Why does this happen? What's happening with Indian men, by the way? Guys, what's going on? Indian men, why are we so lazy? Why? We don't even pick up women anymore. We don't compliment women anymore. The only way we pick up a woman is go up to her, state the obvious and come back. Why are we doing this? Indian man in a club will go up to a girl. If she's wearing a red dress, he'll say hi. Red dress, huh? She knows. And why don't Indian people say, I'll be back. I'll just go and come. There's a reason why Terminator will never be made in India. Imagine Arnold going, I'll just go and come. It's not going to work. And women, stop confusing men. Stop it. How the hell can you call up your husband or a boyfriend and say stupid things like, baby, come faster, but please drive slowly, huh? How do we get home? My girlfriend calls me and says, I miss you. As a man, what do you say? I miss you too, baby. She says, no, you don't. For a second, we actually think like, oh shit. So we say, no, I miss you. She's like, no, you don't. Within 10 minutes, she convinces me and herself that I don't miss her. Then she gets angry with me because I don't miss her. Hangs up the phone saying, you asshole, I don't miss you, dude. What did we miss? And women hear everything the first time. They do. Yeah, married men and relationship, you'll agree with me. You have a fight with your girlfriend or your wife. Men like to have the last word, right? So, yeah, you this, you that. My father told me not to marry you. My mother told me, yeah, your face is like a dog. Okay, you like a hippo. Yeah, usual stuff. And then men do this, right? They turn around because you want the last word. He'll go, softly, bitch. Now, guys, you can say that in your head. You can whisper it in your head. They will hear it. And a simple Gujarati girl becomes Beyonce. I'm sorry, what did you say? And then men get scared. Men, no, baby, nothing. No. Then she teach you like you're 5 years old. No. What did you say? You want to leave the house you're paying rent for and never come back. And after 20 minutes of all this, when she doesn't hear it from you, she says, oh, so I'm a bitch now, huh? You heard it the first time. That's my time, guys. My name is Nitin Mirani. Thank you very much.